tears. He will take away our pain and make all things new. And make all things new. He will wipe away our tears. He will take away our pain and make all things new. All things.
newness, know the newness, see the newness coming to me. I can feel the newness, sense the newness, see the newness, touch the newness, newness everywhere. He made all things new. Shakakayakata. Prophesying, hallelujah. He made all things new. He made all things new. That body is new right now. He made all things new. Newness of finances. He made all things new. Sakatela balada. He made all things new. He made all things new. Revelation chapter number 21. We're going to be praying. I want you to know that this is the time to bring to an end every old order. I don't know how many people that are comfortable with the old order. There are men and women who are comfortable with the old order. They are comfortable. Don't bother yourself about them. There are those who are comfortable with suffering. There are those who are comfortable with begging. There are those who are comfortable with struggling. There are those who are comfortable with pains. There are those who are comfortable with afflictions. There are those who are comfortable with struggles. Please don't try to bother yourself about what men are choosing for themselves. Life is given to everyone individually. You can choose. Revelation chapter number 21, verse number 4 and verse number 5. That's where we're praying from. Then from 2 Corinthians chapter number 5, verse 17. Those are the scriptures. Today you are going to be decreeing that everything that resembles and represents the old order, every manifestation of the old order in your life, everything enforcing the old order in your life, let them be terminated. I wish those in the prayer room will not discourage me or distract me. Everything that represents the old order should be eliminated, should be terminated, should be rooted out. Now listen, I want to read Revelation chapter 21, verse 4 and verse 5. And God shall wipe away tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death. Neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things have passed away. Verse 5. And he that sat upon the throne I make all things new. And he said unto me, write, for these words are true.
Yeah.
2 Corinthians chapter number 5, verse number 17. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is, not that he will be, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. He didn't say old things will pass away. He didn't say old things shall pass away. He didn't say old things may pass away. He didn't say all things would pass away. He didn't say
Jesus,
all things should pass away. He said all things are passed away. Behold, all things. How many things? All things have become new. Now listen. I want you to understand that newness, the making of newness, is God's ultimate agenda for the new creation. How do you answer the new creation with old things? You are a new creation. He makes all things new. And God made all things new for me, and God made all things new for me. The first thing you're going to be praying this afternoon in this midday intercession and prophetic prayer is, Lord, every way that I have loved the oldness over the newness. You know, there are people, because of the self-pity they are getting, they love their sicknesses. Because of the peanuts that people give them, they love their poverty. Because of self-pity, they love their problems. Everything that stayed because of affection. Affliction stays because of affection. Attitudes stay because of affection. If you destroy the affection, what feeds those things will be destroyed. There are people who feel glorious by magnifying their problems. Every time you see them, maybe they are preachers, maybe they are brothers, maybe they are sisters. Every time you see them talking about how big their problems are. You are a new creation. That problem needs to expire today.
Amen.
Not tomorrow. He made all things new. My Father, my Father,
my Father,
in the name of Jesus, I stand on this altar of fire right now, and I declare, I hate the oldness, the old order. I reject them. I reject them from my life, from my family, from my ministry. I reject every old order. I refuse their existence. Now, can you open your mouth and begin to pray? Lord, I reject the old order. 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 In the name of Jesus. Arikata Katarabada, Masekatara Kataya, Rapado Sataya. I reject the old order of sickness, the old
order of suffering, the old order of stagnation, the old order of suffocation, the old order of stagnation, the old order of stagnedness, the old order, Lord, every old order of death, every old order of diseases, every old order of deformity, every old order of deformity, every old order of disaster and destruction, every old order that has been finding expression in my life, I reject you right now. I reject you right now. I have no affection for you. I have no affection for you. I remove you from my life. I uproot you from my life. I reject you right now. I reject the old order. I refuse the old order. Wherever you are, lift your voice and begin to declare, I reject the old order. I throw away the old order from my family, from my ministry, from my calling, from my life. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. There was a man of God, a mighty minister. I don't know which book I was reading, and I read about his testimony. He was invited to minister in a very big place. In fact, he said, he came from America. He said, by the time he got to that place, he said, the whole road was blocked. And then there was no phone, no GSM. So he couldn't communicate that they were coming with the people that went to wait for him in the airport. They couldn't find the road. And he knew that if he had to start going there, before he gets to the stadium, the crusade will close. He told the people that were carrying him, is there any small church, any church around here where I can fellowship for today so that we can continue tomorrow? Men with right attitude. Men who do not think that God is small because the congregation or the people are small. He said, the man said, there's a church, a young church, that is having a crusade by the road, that's having a meeting by the road. He said, let me go there. They packed and he went inside there, sat down. He said they were about, I don't think they were up to 20. Whereas they were waiting for him as a guest minister in the stadium. He sat there. He said, one young lady stood up, walked up to him, and began to prophesy to him. Guess what? Everything that he was going through, that he has been praying for, was what that lady was prophesying and giving him exact date that it will be solved. So he says, so God took me from America to this place, not for me to minister to people, but for me to be ministered to. Let me tell you why men remain in the old order, because of bad mindset and mentality. My Father, in the name of Jesus, every mentality and mindset that has kept me in the old order, oh Lord, let it be destroyed. I refuse, I reject old mentalities and old mindset. Can you open your mouth and pray wherever you are? Every mentality, pride mentality, arrogant mentality, every mentality that has helped me, oh Lord, bow the Lord, and backward, oh Lord, in the old order, in the old order, in the old order, in the old order, let it be broken, let it be broken, let it be broken, let it be broken, let it be uprooted. Every thought pattern, every thought pattern, every mentality, every thought pattern, every thought pattern that has helped me, that has helped me, that has beat me, that
has placed me in the old altar, let it be broken. Let it be broken. Let it be uprooted. Let it be uprooted. Let it be uprooted. Let it be uprooted. I repent, oh God. I repent of old mentality. I repent of old mindset. I repent of old thought processes, old thought patterns. I repent, oh God, of thinking like a mere man. I repent of fleshy mentality, of ungodly mindset. I repent right now. I repent right now. Uproot every mindset that has become a fitting ground for the old altar in my life. In the name of Jesus, take it down right now. Uproot it right now. Give me a new mindset. Give me a new mentality. A spiritual mentality. A humble disposition. A humble disposition. A humble mindset. A humble mentality. A humble mentality. A teachable mentality. My Father. My Father. Take hold of my mind. Fix my mind. Readjust my mind. Reset my mind. If you are going to make all things new for me, I will have a new mind. I must possess a new mind. I must possess a new mind. I must think differently. I must see things differently. I must see you differently. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Every man you see on earth not having his portion in life, it does not matter how much you pity him, his problems will remain until he changes his mindset. Listen, when you change your mindset, your attitude towards spiritual things will change. You will not be lackadaisical. You will not be nonchalant. You will not take any spiritual thing for granted. Because every spiritual setup is your setup. I have come to realize that every spiritual event is my event. Like somebody walked into this prayer and you looked and you walked out. Why? Because you have an attitude that tells you it's not for you. Yet you are suffering. Yet you are struggling. Yet you are in pain. I wake up every day and say, God, create your opportunity for a shift in my life. It doesn't matter how insignificant that opportunity is. Create an opportunity for a change for me. For change is constant. If you are not changing, it's a sign that you have stagnated. Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Fix my mouth.
Fix my mouth.
As you fix my mind.
As you fix
don't
my
begin
mind.
To speak newness.
Don't begin to speak
and
newness.
Stop confessing and oldness. Stop confessing. Open your mouth and pray. This day is for me, O God. This day is my day, O God. This is my day, Father. Baratayata, Rakate, Yatata Rada, Inspector Rekatosha, Mantala Katayata, Mantala Katayata, Mantala Katayata, Marashanda Barata, Marashanda Barata, Eroka Kataya. Oh God, adjust my tongue, that my tongue will become the pen of a ready writer, writing New Testament, writing New Epistles, writing New Epistles for my own destiny. I want to rewrite my history by speaking newness. I want to rewrite my life by speaking newness. Adjust my tongue. Adjust my tongue. Don't begin to speak newness. It does not matter how bad it looks. It does not matter how terrible it looks. It is well with my soul. It is well with my body. It is well with my ministry. It is well with my children. It is well with my wife. It is well with my wife. It is well with my house. It is well, O God. Arashata kadarata, basheketere kadaraba, riatara kadarata, basheketere kadaya, ratata darata. I speak newness everywhere. I
I see newness and I speak newness. Lord, open my heart to the newness you are creating. Open my eyes to the newness you have created for me. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. Listen, and I'm showing you the M hindrances, M activators of old order. I've talked about mindset and mentality. Wrong mindset and mentality will fix you in the old order. Nobody can help you. Listen, let me teach you something. Every man you have seen that has ever shifted ground began to shift ground in his mind. The way he perceives things, the way he sees things, the way she sees things, the way he interprets things. Nothing is ordinary to anybody. That must make a difference. Nothing is ordinary. Everything means something. Mindset, mentality. So it begins from the mind. If the old order is not destroyed in your mind, there is no amount of mantle that can shift your life. They will place any kind of mantle for you. You will move and return back to where you're coming from. Number two is your mouth. Your mouth can keep you in the old order for a very long time. Number three, men. I have found out that many men have remained in the old order because they surrounded themselves with men with nosediving attitudes. Listen, if you are in a company of people that are nosediving, you cannot skyrocket for your ascendancy in life. Or descent in life is determined by your association. I've found out that the Bible said the companion of fools will be destroyed. He said, but he that goeth with wise men shall be wise. I found out that many people have downplayed the importance of men in their lives. When we talk about men, we are talking about relationships. People you are connected to. If you are connected, the Bible says that's Proverbs 13 verse 20. He that walketh with wise men shall be wise, but the companion of fools shall be destroyed. Listen, you don't have to be a fool. Just be a companion of fools. Your destruction is waiting. One of the things that damages men's life and the opportunity for newness is to connect with those who have no desire for newness. You link your life with women and men who have no hunger for newness, who are not passionate for newness, who do not desire, you don't see them striving for newness. Forget it. They will drag you down. I need to tell the story of the monkeys and we begin to pray. You are going to make a disconnection. Everything that does not make me progress, everyone that does not make me progress in the direction of newness must live my life. Is your life, oh? Is your life. Now there is this monkey that was introduced. This monkey was kept hungry for some days. So he was introduced in a big hall like this and they tied banana to the end of the hall but opened it very well. So the monkey came in and saw the banana and he rushed, jumped to take the banana. But somebody was waiting behind the ceiling and the person used cane and struck the head of the monkey and poured very ice water, cold water on the head of the monkey. So the monkey shuddered and he said, banana, cold water, bulala. Banana, cold water, bulala. He jumped again, they flogged it, poured it cold water. He looked at the banana. He went towards the entrance door and sat down. I was looking at the banana. I was calculating in his monkey brain. This is bulala cold water. Bulala cold water. He sat still. He was hungry. But that banana is not worth it. Another monkey was introduced that was very hungry. That monkey came and saw banana, looked at the one sitting, looked. He ran. That one grabbed it and was telling it in the monkey language that thing is cold water bulala, cold water bulala. He didn't listen. He shook him off and ran. As he jumped up, they beat it only once and poured cold water. The other one got his own 3 beatings. This one got only one. He said, now I understand it is cold water, bulala. Sorry for disobeying you. He came and sat with the other monkey. They introduced the third monkey. He wanted to jump. He first of all, look at 2 monkeys. Look at banana. He wanted to go. They just told him in monkey language. They didn't even drag him. They said, cold water, bulala. He sat down with them. He didn't make attempt. They introduced the next monkey, looked at banana and sat with others. He didn't make attempt. If this is banana, these monkeys will not be sitting here. They introduced 30 monkeys. Each one came in and sat down. Each one. They didn't ask what happened to the first 2. They just saw monkeys sitting. All of them were looking at banana. The other ones didn't experience it, but by association, they decided to leave other people's experience. God forbid.
My father, I will not manifest or leave any other man's experience. I refuse the negativity, of another man. I disconnect my life from everyone that has insisted on the old order. I break free now. I break free, Lord, from the borrowed mentality by association. I break free, Lord, from the borrowed mindset, wrong mindset, borrowed mentality, borrowed afflictions, borrowed words, borrowed vocabularies that has kept me in lack, kept me in pain, kept me in affliction. Help me, oh God, it's not moving forward. I break free by the blood. I break free by the blood. I dissolve such connection. I destroy it now. I free my spirit from every connection that has held me backward in the old order. It's my season of newness. It's my season of newness. It's my season of newness. I will have it differently. I will have it differently. I will have it differently. My new season has come. The season of new order. The season of newness. Rekeshata kadala deya. Radada 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 radada. Open your mouth and say, my father, I receive my newness now. Open your mouth and pray right now. My mouth is set. I speak newness. My mind is set. My connection is solid with newness, oh God. I receive newness. I receive newness. I receive newness. I receive newness. New cars, new houses, new ministries, new men, new helpers, new revelations, new increase, new mantle, new increase, new strength, new health, new impact, new impartation, new blessings. Newness on every side. In Jesus' name we are praying.
Amen. Saints of God, tomorrow we are going to war a warfare against every spirit of the old order. Every force that say that what your father suffered, you will suffer. That what your brothers are going through is what you will go through. There are families where sickness is traveling DNA and bloodline. Afflictions travel. Poverty travel. Pains travel. That
thing that came from your mother dies in your body in the name of Jesus.
Amen. They say it was in her blood. That's why he entered you.
If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. All things are past. They have passed. They have passed. Kalika do shata. If I be a man of God, I rise up with the word of God and I command that all things in your life, in your body, in your family, let them die by fire.
Amen. Your father struggled and you are struggling. An end has come to it.
Yes, amen.
Your family was stranded and now you have no help around you. An end has come for it.
Amen.
They lacked money and now your life looks like you are going to beg. I say, by the power of the newness of life, in the name of Jesus, I summon your helpers from east, west, north and south, from heaven. Let them appear in your season in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will see them.
Amen.
They will show up.
Amen.
Whatever covered them will not cover you again.
Amen.
You will be seen. You will be heard.
Amen.
Whatever stench of the oldness that when people perceive it, they don't want to help you, it is erased from your life.
Amen.
New fragrance.
Amen.
As I speak about this, I saw a vision. A vision. I just saw a vision. What vision did I see? I saw a vision of a hand holding perfume. It's holding perfume. Please get me the perfume. I want to do something prophetic. Get me the perfume from my car right now. I want to do something very prophetic right now. Carito satire. I saw hands holding perfume and people were collecting perfumes and spreading all over their body. New fragrance. Stenches and odors of repulsion are being neutralized by the spirit right now. They are being neutralized. Don't think that what I'm about to do right now will not get to you. It will. It will. It will. It will. It will. It will get to you. What I saw in the spirit, I want to do. I will spread this perfume into the air 7 times. Listen, there was a day I was praying in 2017 on fragrance. And a man of God called me and said, "Man of God, do you know? They are supposed to do so, so and so for my church since January. And this is June of another year." He said, like in January 2022, but this is June of 2023. In that year, he said, "They are not picking my calls." I say, "It is because your fragrance has been manipulated." He said, "You are smelling like a stench where you are supposed to be smelling like a scent." And we prayed, and I say, "In Jesus' name, we remove the stench. And we release the fragrance." Guess what? He put a call through that day. They answered him. And he asked them, "Concerning this thing, when is it going to be done?" Guess what? They said to him, "Choose a date. Choose a date now." And he chose a date. 1 month after that day, the whole thing he was expecting to be done was done immediately. By the prophetic, the power of prophecy, those of you who believe, in 2 Chronicles 20:20, which say, "Believe in his prophets, so shall you prosper." I do what I feel the Spirit is leading me to do. I know that this fragrance will smell here, but the Spirit will carry it to wherever you are. And it will neutralize every stench upon your being. Father, in the name of Jesus, I spray out this fragrance 1. I spray it out 2. I spray it out 3. I spray it out 4. I spray it out 5. I spray it out 6. I spray it out 7.
Oh Lord, let the fragrance go right now. Amen. Let the air carry right now. Amen. Let the wind carry right now. Amen. Upon men right now. Amen. Upon women right now. Amen. Upon families right now. Amen. Fragrance of newness. Amen. Fragrance of newness. Amen. Upon your ministry. Amen. Upon your life. Amen. Upon your wife. Amen. Upon your children. Amen. Upon your calling. Amen. Upon your body. Amen. Every stench is removed right now. Amen. You smell sweet. There is an attraction. Attraction to your helpers. Attraction to your helpers. Attraction to your helpers. Even helpers that don't know you will smell you from afar. They will smell you from afar. They will smell your name from afar. Every stench that cover your name is broken right now in the name of Jesus.
Listen to me. I don't do what I have not seen. There was a time everyone hated me. Everyone. People were complaining left and right. And God said to me, your problem is the stench. The enemy has put a stench on your life. Attack the stench and remove it. And soak yourself in the fragrance of the Spirit. I can't remember how many people that hate me now. I can't count. Everywhere I turn now, people are like, oh, praise God. Let me spray Jare on my body. What are you doing? This is just nothing. But it's the spirit of faith behind it. Today, I declare by the word of prophecy that where you have been repelled and rejected, you shall be received.
Amen.
And recognized.
Amen.
And recognized.
Amen.
When you enter, the fragrance of heaven will fill everywhere.
Amen.
People will see your post from today and it will smell sweet.
Amen.
People will see your picture and it will smell sweet.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Thank you,
Father. Newness.
Amen.
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 God said I should tell somebody. God said I should tell somebody that what you are asking him for is too small. That he wanted to give you $1 million. And you are asking him for 1 million naira. He said he will not answer that prayer until you are ready. Hey! He made all things new. 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 Hear what the Lord is saying. He said, for the past 15 years, I prepared somebody who will give you $1 million. 15 years now. He said, after 15 years, you have not yet believed you worth more than what you are. He said, I will shock you. When you begin to see yourself in the new light of what I have made you, he said, I will shock you with men who will shock you. Thank you, Ancient of Days. Tomorrow afternoon, we are seeing again on midday intercession and prophetic prayer. We just finished our Monday prayers. And our beloved men of God that I call my company. You know, I was telling you about having your own association. In our association, we know the hide mouth. We know the men of God who gather to, if you are messing up, we'll be clapping for you and telling you that your poo is smelling sweet. We know they do like that. Oh no, we know. We flock, we beat you. Our company is a different one. And we just finish our Monday. Every Monday, we gather to pray together. And after the prayers, the men of God didn't rush out. They decided to pray with us. We will still have some of them coming up to pray when they are chanced. We'll check when they are chanced within this week, next week. In the month of August, they will still come and be a blessing to you. I celebrate all our men of God present in the house. Come on, let's clap our hands for Jesus, for them. Let's celebrate them in the presence of God. Hallelujah. Glory. I'll see you again tomorrow. This is Midday Intercession and Prophetic Prayer, reminding you that where there are people to pray, there is the living God to answer them. God bless you. Do have a wonderful time as our minister sings for us. God bless you.
Hey, Sunday. Sunday, and I know Sunday, and I know Sunday.
Kingdom Kings Church International, KKCI.
He's made all things new. Made all things new. Yeah. Yeah. All things are new. Kalano Sadia. All things new. Yeah. All things new. Things new, he made all things new. Yeah. He made all things new in my life. He made all things new. He made all things new. All things new in my away my tears, and he is taking